Hello, I am Dr. Rajneesh Sardana. I am a senior consultant cardiology, head of pacing electrophysiology at the Manipal Heart Institute in New Delhi. Today I am going to be talking about atrial fibrillation. Atrial fibrillation is a condition, it's an electrical abnormality of the heart in which the heart rate and the pulse become irregular. So when a person feels, it is going to be not a regular rhythm as we usually are used to at a rate of about 70. Here it can be fast, it can be irregular, it will be going haywire, jumping up and down. A person may be able to appreciate his own heart beating, which is going irregular, or it may be picked up by the cardiologist. It's a condition which leads to a lot of consequences, which a patient may not be symptomatic, but still the consequences are dire. The biggest consequence which is a stroke. And the Indian Heart Rhythm Association is promoting this month as a Atrial Fibrillation Education Month to promote awareness amongst general populations, as it can be asymptomatic in large number of patients. And the first presentation could be a stroke. The stroke can be devastating with hemiparesis, paralysis of one half of the body, and these can be prevented by giving newer modern medications. So atrial fibrillation, I'll repeat, is a condition in which the heart rate becomes irregular, it is fast, and a person can feel his own palpitations. The moment he tries to walk, it goes fast. He can feel dizzy, not feeling well, and the pulse is picked up. It can be because of various conditions like valvular heart disease, leaks in the mitral valves or one of the valves in the heart. It can be related to thyroid abnormality. It can be related to certain deficiencies, and it can also be related to hypertension and elderly. It's a pretty common problem beyond 60 years of life, and almost about 10% patients between 70 to 80 years of age would get atrial fibrillation. As I said, the biggest consequence is a stroke, a paralysis of one of the body. Why does it happen? Because the irregularity, the heart pumping is bizarre. It's not actually pumping, it is shaking or shivering, which leads to clot formations in the heart. And the clot can go to the brain and produce a stroke. What is recommended, and it's been now pretty well studied, and the recommendations are pretty firm, that we need to put these patients on anticoagulation, which means blood thinners, which means the medications which prevent clotting of the blood in the heart. So to prevent clotting, we give these medicines, and the strokes, which are usually to the tune of 5 times the normal heart rhythm patients, can be decreased by about 80% with these medications. So awareness of atrial fibrillation is very, very important amongst patients. Any person who feels that the pulse is not good, is not feeling good, should consult their doctor, cardiologist, and better to consult a cardiac electrophysiologist, which are the rhythm specialists, to look after their rhythm abnormalities. The downside of these blood thinners is that there's a risk of bleeding, because these patients, the blood will not clot. But overall, if out of 10 patients, 9 would benefit, one would probably also have, or less than one would even have a risk of bleeding. But the thrust is that we should anticoagulant all patients of atrial fibrillation for preventing strokes and leading to disability in future life. Thank you.